Saturday YouTube, Miss Antonio with Combiner War stuff. I got more chunks of combiners to form bigger ones. Gestalls, as they're called. These are going to make one big old combiner. This is Protectobot Blades. Of the Protectobots, he will make Defensor's arm officially, but he can be a leg, I think, as well. This guy looks almost, I think this guy is just a slight remold of Alpha Bravo, or vice versa. How's that? So we're not going to really dwell too much on it, but we will take him out, have a little fun, and see what this guy does individually. All right, baby, we got helicopter mode. Look at this guy. He's basically just a repaint of Alpha Bravo, which was part of the original Superion set. So, if you watch my Alpha Bravo review, you will get a little bit more in-depth, I guess, transformation and stuff. I'm not going to do a montage again because, well, we already did that for this figure, this mold at least. The only differences in the mold here are the head sculpt and then the paint scheme. So you got a lot of rescue stuff. You even have so far as to say Autobot, what's that say? I can't read it. Coastal Rescue? Autobot Coastal Rescue? That's kind of cool. I've never seen that before. Never really looked that close. There's little anchors in there and stuff. It's got rescue a couple different places. The little white and red stripey definitely looks like a rescue vehicle. However, if you look at his bio, he is a maniac who likes to chop Decepticons up with his blades. Now, these things are molded in those arms here, these missiles, which aren't really indicative of a rescue vehicle, as well as the chain gun with giant shells on it, too. That can be put anywhere you can find a little hole for it. So if you wanted to mount it down here, kind of looks neat, but then when I tried to display it for you to review, it just kind of topples over on its side unnaturally. Let's see robot mode. Very cool figure. I'm liking it quite a bit. Love the color scheme. The red, the silver, the gray, the white, all of that. Looks really good. And he's got that blue face, which I'm pretty certain he had in the days of G1. However, I thought Blades had a mask. Like, he had one of those Scramble City combiner, typical little face mask, no mouth having dude. So, I don't know if I like that. And maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm completely wrong. But I kind of thought he did. So, you tell me. Tell me if I'm right or wrong. Does Blades in the G1 continuity have a little face mask thing? Yeah, that's it. I mean, this is flat out, once again, remolded Alpha Bravo. You can, and I pointed this out in my other review, you can do what you want with this stuff here in the back. This is how I choose to display it. I kind of just kind of tuck these guys in back here. You can have them hang down the sides, out, whatever you like. That's how I like it. I fold it up, make it neat and tidy. And that's it. We have a couple missiles here molded in, which I don't believe Alpha Bravo had. He did. I'm sorry. I'm looking at him right over here. He's in arm mode. So let me grab him in arm mode. How's that? I'll just show that off. There he is. There he is in arm mode. So this guy's going to form the an arm similar to him. That's it. that's what he would look like. I'm not going to give you the side-by-side. You can imagine what they would be like if they were both transformed the same. So that's it. I'm in Santona. I'm just messing around right now, having some fun with some Protectobots. We will have the full collection as well as build Defensor. So stay tuned for that Gestalt build as well as Devastator. And if you haven't seen it, I've got the Aerial Bots and Constunicons done too. So go ahead and check those out. I may even put them in their own separate playlist for ease of viewing. Take care, guys. Thanks for watching. Go get the stuff at Big Bad Toy Store and have yourselves a fantastic day.